Hi, I'm Dave Parsons. I'm National Postgraduate Director for the Mind Lab, and this short video is to fill in a few details about research.
So this is a mind map that I've created from some of the ideas that came up in the classes when we used Mindmap as a collaborative tool. I've drawn those together into another mind map that I've drawn here in XMind, and at the centre of it is the concept of research and the underlying question of what is research. So that's really what we looked at, and what I tried to do was to extract out the various ideas that came up and to identify some subtrees. So what I ended up with was five general areas in which I've put the various ideas that came up in the class. So for example, we have problems with research, aims of research, sources for research, ways of researching, and outcomes of research. And I guess if we were going to focus on something that would be our first point of contact, it might be the aims of research. So let's have a little look at what we see as the aims of research. So the things that came up in the other mind maps that were done in the classes were things like challenging thinking, justifying assumptions, discovery, applying, informing decision making, investigating, expanding thinking, testing assumptions, and so on. And so we can see there's a whole different set of ranges of aims of research where we might have different ideas. So we might be wanting to find out something new, or we might want to be addressing something that we already believe or think we disagree with, or we might want to be finding out something that will help us in the future to guide us to new decisions and further research that we might do. So we can see that there are many different aims of research. So what might we think about next in terms of these research components? Well, I guess the next thing we might consider would be ways of researching. So assuming we know what it is we want to research in terms of the general type of research we're going to do, what ways would we actually do the research? Well, again, there were lots of ideas that came up. So we had things that were to do with research methods, approaches, ways of reasoning, different types of data. So research methods can be quantitative, qualitative. Indeed, you can see those distinctions made further down in the data. So we might be doing, if you like, hard numerical statistical analysis. We might be doing empirical experiments. Or we might be doing something which is a bit more qualitative, interviews, observations, trials. We might be mixing our methods. So there are lots of different research methods, and we have to choose the right one for the type of study we're doing. There are different ways of approaching our research. We might have some kind of inquiry. We might be defining specific hypotheses. We might be postulating specific research questions. And so some of these things are more specific than others. It depends on the nature of what we're trying to do. There are different ways in which we might apply reasoning: abductive, deductive, inductive, and so on. And there's different types of data that we might gather. We might gather qualitative data. We might gather quantitative data. We might be gathering data from different types of subjects. So depending on the aims of our research, we may choose different ways of researching and trying to find the appropriate match between the aims and the ways. So what would be our sources for research if we've made a decision to research something? Where do we look? Well, initially, of course, before we actually do, for example, experiments, surveys, observations, and so on, we need to do our literature reviews. We need to find out what the state of the art already is. And those sources might be the more traditional ones, like books, journals, conference proceedings. Or these days, of course, there's a lot more electronic material, websites, and blogs. And there are other sources of research too, for example, experts. The Delphi method is a research method that involves asking experts to comment on things in a structured way. And indeed, you might regard focus groups as another way of gathering people's expertise. So there are, again, many different sources for research. So when we've thought about those things, what about the problems with research? Well, there may be a number of barriers to doing your research. For example, you may find it difficult to get ethics approval to, for example, do stuff with children in a class. You might have trouble getting funding for research. You might have to go through a peer review process before you can even get your research going. And then later on, you might have to go through another peer review process in order to try and get it published in a respected journal or conference. So there can be many problems. And of course, just like the rest of life, people's personal agendas, their bias, their political viewpoints can get in the way. And so we often find that our research is successful or not necessarily depending on the quality of that research, but on the opinions of others. And ultimately, we're interested in the outcomes of research. So what might that be? Well, possibly increasing the knowledge base, finding answers to our research questions. We might be looking at many different views of the outcomes of research. And sometimes we want to move on from that research. We want to be able to make new predictions. We want to be able to infer new understandings from the research. And of course, move on from it. One of the things, for example, that appears at the end of most academic papers is future work. Where can this work take us next? So we can see with all of these different viewpoints that there are lots of different perspectives on research. There are many different ways that you can consider research. There are many, many variations in the way that you would construct your own research projects, undertake those projects, gather the data, process the data, and disseminate it in different ways for its outcomes. So the trick really is to choose the things that fit best with the topics, the interest, and the hoped for outcomes that you want for your own particular research projects. So in this Prezi, I'm going to ask the question again, what is research? But in this case, I'm going to ask a sub-question, which is, what is education research? But let's start off with the definition which comes from the TEC. Research is original investigation undertaken in order to contribute to knowledge and understanding and, in the case of some disciplines, cultural innovation or aesthetic refinement. So what's important about this definition is that it's quite broad. It doesn't confine itself only to the traditional idea of finding new knowledge, but it also thinks about culture, and it thinks about aspects of art, film, music, and so on. So we can see that research is not just writing a journal paper, but it may be a whole range of things which are in some way creative and innovative. And the cultural aspect is particularly important in New Zealand. We have Mataranga Māori research, which helps to sustain Māori culture and delivers economic value to New Zealand. So there's this important concept of cultural capital, that there are aspects of research that can lead to social and economic benefits. We might ask the question in the context of education, what's the relationship between research and professional development? Well, the NZQA say that maintaining professional currency alone is not considered as being research active, but active research can contribute to maintaining professional currency. So this is particularly important for the course that you're doing, because we're giving you the opportunity to think very carefully about how you can do research, which will of course feed back into your own professional development and professional activities. So we're looking very much at applied research that has some useful outcomes to you as teachers. So what's specifically education research? Well, here's a definition from the American Educational Research Association. Education research is the scientific field of study that examines education and learning processes and the human attributes, interactions, organizations, and institutions that shape educational outcomes. And again, we see this is a very broad definition. So when we talk about education research, we don't just mean, for example, looking at what happens with a group of learners in a classroom. But we might look at a whole range of other larger interactions, different worlds of education. So we might be looking at large organizations, institutions, collections of organizations, ministries, governments, international networks, and so on. So we can see that education research can really range from the very small study to the very large. And here's another quote from a writer called Marlene Morrison, who says educational research should be seen not just as a rule-driven means of finding out what educational managers did not know before, even if they suspected, But as an approach to skillful and intellectual inquiry that is rooted in multiple ways of viewing the educational worlds we inhabit. So again, it's this idea of breadth and scale. There are many, many ways that we can consider researching education, many different views of the world, many different perspectives. And so the challenge for us really is to choose a particular approach to research that's useful for us, that interests us, and we feel can feed back into our own professional development and that of our colleagues. I'll just wrap up by mentioning the references used in this presentation. Marlene Morrison's paper is quite interesting. It's called What Do We Mean by Educational Research? You can find it on the web. It's frequently misquoted, as things often are, so people use secondary references. It gets cited as being in a book, which in fact it's not in, but it is available on the web, and it's quite a useful extract from a chapter. The other document used here is the NZQA document that talks about degrees and related qualifications, and that's got quite a lot of detail in it about how the NZQA and the TEC regard research within the context of teaching and learning. This is a short presentation that uses some ideas from John Creswell to think about research questions and how you can script a research question using a fairly common structure. John Creswell has a website, johnwcreswell.com, where he talks a lot about different types of research. Talking about scripts, if you've done any work with agile methods, you may have come across the idea of the agile user story, which very often uses a standard template that goes something like, as a somebody, I want to be able to do something so that I can achieve some result. And you can slot in your requirements for that particular story using that template. And so Creswell's ideas are quite similar to that. So here's a little template he has for qualitative questions. Now it might look a little bit complex, but actually that's only because he gives a number of examples for what you might put in the middle of your qualitative question. So the first bit is the how or what, or even the why in fact, which is the beginning of the question. And then the next part is really rather dependent on the nature of the research that you're doing. So depending on the type of research you want to do, you might pick different combinations of words, and you're by no means limited to the ones that Creswell suggests, but you need to, in some way, imply the type of study that you're doing, the type of research that you're doing. And then we want to define the phenomenon, the thing that you're looking at, for the participants at a research site. So let's look at how we might take that little template and slot things into the blanks. What is the impact on engagement? So we've got a what question. And then we've got the context of our study, the type of research that we're doing. In this case, it's the impact on engagement in learning. So that kind of slots in as the type of study we're doing. And then we can see that the phenomenon that we're investigating is device addiction. We can see that the participants in the study are students. And we can see that the location is my school. So the point about using this little sort of qualitative structure is just to make sure that we've thought about the different components that would go inside a qualitative research question. And what about a quantitative question? Well, they're a little bit more focused, I guess. So Creswell suggests this structure. Does this theory explain the relationship between the independent variable and the dependent variable, controlling for the effects of the control variable, or in fact many control variables perhaps? So what we've got to decide here is, well, what is my independent variable? What is the thing that doesn't get moved around by other things? What is the dependent variable, the thing that I'm trying to move around by managing my independent variable? And what are the other variables that I need to try and control so they don't get in the way of my results? So what might this look like if we use that? Well, the one at the top is a standard sort of scientific approach, so Boyle's Law. Does Boyle's Law explain the relationship between pressure and temperature controlling for the effects of volume? Boyle's Law, like Ohm's Law and a number of other similar sort of physical laws, is based on different variables that can affect each other. So it's a fairly standard thing. But how would that work with an education quantitative question? Well, how about social constructivism? You know, theory of the decade probably in education. Does social constructivism explain the relationship between student activity and learning outcomes, controlling for the effects of prior learning? So what we're looking at here is our independent variable is the student activity, so that's the one that we can manage. The learning outcomes is the dependent variable. How much does that change as a result of the student activity? And we need to control the external effects of other variables like prior learning to make sure that the results don't get distorted by things that the students already know. So you may find these structures an interesting way of trying to put research questions together. This is the reference, Research Design, Qualitative, Quantitative and Mixed Methods Approaches. It's just one of many things that Cresswell's written, and you can go to his website and pick up a number of materials.